지금부터 반공화국 적대 행위를 감행하다가 적발 체포된 미국 보지니아 종합대학 학생 완비어 오토 프레드리크의 요청에 따른 기자회견을 시작하겠습니다. 먼저 완비어가 발언하겠습니다.
First, I would like to thank everyone for coming to the press conference that I eagerly requested to have. I would also like to show my sincere gratitude to the government of the DPR Korea for giving me this opportunity to apologize for my crime, to beg for forgiveness, and to beg for any assistance to save my life. On December 29th, 2015, I entered the DPR Korea as a tourist. On January 1st, 2016, New Year's Day, I committed severe crimes against both the people and the government of the DPR Korea. Due to this crime, on January 2nd, 2016, I was detained and I am currently under investigation. My name is Otto Frederick Warmbier. I am 21 years old. I am a student of finance at the University of Virginia. I am in my third year at the university. My residential address is 225 West Hill Lane, Cincinnati, Ohio, United States, with my family. At the moment, I live in a rented apartment at 600 Preston Place, Charlottesville, Virginia, near my university. My father, Frederick Warmbier, owns a very small factory called Finishing Cincinnati Black Oxide, that barely makes enough to support my family. My mother, Cindy Warmbier, is a housewife. I am the oldest son in my family. My brother, Austin Warmbier, and my sister, Greta Warmbier, are both high school students in Cincinnati, Ohio, United States. On January 1st, 2016, I committed the crime of taking out a political slogan from the staff-only area of the Yangokto International Hotel. The slogan inspires the people's love for their system. The task was given by the Friendship United Methodist Church. At the encouragement of the Z Society and the connivance of the United States administration, I came to commit this crime task. The aim of this crime was to harm the work ethic and motivation of the Korean people. This was a very foolish aim. Growing up in the United States, I was taught that the DPR Korea is a mysterious, isolated communist nation from education and mass media. This made an innocent-minded, adventurous young man, like myself, want to show my bravery, to improve my reputation, and show a Western victory over the DPR Korea. I was told by colleagues that North Korea is a beautiful country with great architecture, and that if I was interested in communist nations, I needed to consider a visit. Based on this recommendation, I started to consider my visit. Then, in January 2016, I was scheduled to take a university-sponsored financial class in Hong Kong. I decided to use this opportunity to visit the DPR Korea as a tourist before my financial class. I asked my father and my brother to travel with me while I emailed both UK Choreo Tours and UK Young Pioneer Tours in August 2015. But it was too expensive, and they are very busy, so they could not travel with me. I chose Young Pioneer Tours because it was cheaper. I gave my father $800, and he agreed to pay the other $400 to cover the entire $1,200 cost of a Young Pioneer's tour of the DPR Korea. Based on my application's confirmation, I chose to have my tour at the end of December 2015. Well, then, on September 23rd, 2015, I was having dinner at my friend Stephen Webb's home with him and his mother, Sharon Webb. Stephen is a high school classmate, and he currently attends Ohio State University. We are close friends, we live nearby, and we have known each other for 10 years. Sharon is a deaconess in the Friendship United Methodist Church, and her son, Stephen, is an active believer in this same church. Sharon emphasized that her church does not support the government of North Korea and that communism should be ended. She said that communist nations rally around political slogans. She asked me to take an important political slogan from North Korea to be hung in her church as a trophy. She continued to say that by taking this slogan, we would weaken the unity and motivation of the North Korean people and show this country an insult from the West. She knew how desperately I needed a car to drive to my job this summer, so she offered me a used car worth $10,000 if I was successful. And she said if I was detained and not returned, her church would make payment to my mother of $200,000 in a way of a charitable donation. This is the amount that I am expected to pay for my brother and sister's university tuition out of the $400,000 total. Then she showed me the Friendship United Methodist Church's official bank account statement with $42 million. Well, at first, due to fear, I was hesitant. But since my family suffers from severe financial difficulties, I started to consider this as my only golden opportunity to earn money. Most importantly, Sharon said to never mention the Friendship United Methodist Church, or no payments would come. In early October 2015, I informed my mother very little of my crime attempt offer, but I told her that I planned to steal something precious from North Korea, and, if detained, her bank account would receive transfers for my brother and sister's university tuition. She cried and said not to do anything dangerous. I considered less, not wanting to hurt my mother. But since then, I received several alluring pressures from the Friendship United Methodist Church, leading me to finally decide on my crime attempt. In the meantime, the Z Society also clandestinely encouraged my act. After I came to know that all members get high-paying jobs when they graduate, I eagerly wanted to join the Z Society. In late November 2015, I intentionally revealed my plan of my act to a member of the Z Society who is also currently a student at the University of Virginia. He said that my act would certainly help with the Z Society's goal of spreading freedom and eliminating tyranny. He promised if I was successful, he would help me gain membership in the Z Society. He even said if I was caught, the Z Society could help pressure North Korea for my release. Finally, he said to never mention the Z Society's encouragement. After I planned in detail to accomplish my plan, I arrived in Pyongyang on December 29th, 2015, through Beijing. On the early morning of January 1st, 2016, I committed my crime of taking out the important political slogan from the staff-only area of the Yanggakdo International Hotel, aimed at harming the work ethic and the motivation of the Korean people. After committing my crime against the people and government of the DPR Korea, I was detained on January 2nd, 2016, at the Pyongyang International Airport. I was clearly given the task by the Friendship United Methodist Church. I was encouraged by the Z Society. The United States administration already knows about my act through the CIA, which is closely linked to the Z Society, and connived at my crime. My crime is very severe and pre-planned. I regret my actions more than anything. I apologize to both the Korean people and the government. I beg for forgiveness, and I beg for help in any way possible to save my life. Thank you very much for your attention during my speech.
왕비어의 발언이 끝났습니다. 들으신 바와 같이 미 행정부는 우리 공화국을 반대하는 정말 더러운 행위를 감행하고 있습니다. 질문이 있으면 제기해 주십시오.
조선중앙통신사 기자입니다. 우리나라 단일교회가 구입을 왜 당신에게 주었다고 생각합니다.
Thank you for your question. I will now address why the Friendship United Methodist Church gave me this task. The Friendship United Methodist Church is located in Cincinnati, Ohio, United States. I have known about this church since my childhood because I grew up in Cincinnati, Ohio, United States. You can easily find detailed information on this church from the internet. The Friendship United Methodist Church is not a typical church. It is very wealthy, with $42 million. That is why the United States administration has very close ties with this church. This church made a plan to enter into anti-Christian countries, which the United States administration dislikes, and it is currently implementing this plan. Several Democratic congressmen regularly visit this church to collect political fund donations and to assure their continued support of this church's policy. It is said that in 2008, around $10 million, around 2 to 3% of President Barack Obama's total election cost was collected from this church. That is one of the reasons why the United States administration works closely with the Friendship United Methodist Church and connives at all acts, including my crime. The United States administration and the politicians use the Friendship United Methodist Church to harm the DPR Korea by all dirty ways and means. The Friendship United Methodist Church gave me my crime task, which is closely matched to the United States administration's hostile policy against the DPR Korea, in order to spread Christianity in the DPR Korea and to increase the church's support from the United States administration. Therefore, my crime is the expected output of the United States administration's consistent hostile policy against the DPR Korea and its implementation by the Friendship United Methodist Church. I was easily manipulated because of my family's severe financial difficulties. And because I am a non-believer, the church knew that it could deny its involvement if my crime were to become public news. I hope that answers your question, and you now all clearly understand the Friendship United Methodist Church's involvement in my crime. Thank you all for your attention.
지투협회가 당신의 범죄를 부추겼다고 했는데 그 협회가 어떤 조직인지 당신이 알고 있는 것만큼 이야기해 주십시오.
Thank you very much for your question. I will now address the Z Society and its encouragement of my crime. The Z Society is the most secret organization at the University of Virginia. All members and activities are strictly confidential. I first came to know of the Z Society in September 2013, when I had first started at the university. I saw large Z crests painted on all the buildings at the compound. You can see them if you visit to the University of Virginia. I was told that they are from the Z Society, since the Society donates millions of dollars to the university. The Z Society has around 10 student members currently, and after graduation, they all go on to become very wealthy, with jobs in politics, business, and religion. Members of the Z Society include former United States President Woodrow Wilson and a former head of the CIA. The stated objective of the Z Society is to spread freedom and eliminate tyranny. In order to become members, they must have good grades and leadership, and, most importantly, they must commit a brave act to help with the society's stated objective. Once again, all members and activities are strictly confidential. It is, well, clear that the Z Society knew of my good grades and leadership. It is also clear that they knew that I would eagerly want to join the society in order to solve my family's desperate financial problems. Because of this, the Z Society expected me to commit a brave act to help eliminate tyranny. In order to prove my braveness to the Z Society, I committed my crime in the DPR Korea with hopes of joining the Z Society. As you know from the Cold War era example, the CIA has always been leading anti-communism in every place in the world. There is no doubt that the CIA knows of the Z Society's encouragement of my crime. Lastly, I want to clearly state that I was the political victim of the United States' consistent hostile policies against the DPR Korea. I innocently tried to earn money through my crime. In order to accomplish its political interests, the United States administration does not distinguish between friendly and enemy countries. Therefore, they manipulate people, like myself, to commit crimes in those countries. I wish that others do not follow in my footsteps. I hope all of you can now understand the Z Society's encouragement of my crime. Thank you all for listening.
존변조선신보 기자입니다. 당신이 범죄를 감행하기 위하여 미국에서 면밀한 준비를 했다고 하는데 그에 대하여 이야기해 주세요.
Thank you for your question. I will now explain the preparations that I took while in the United States. I took many detailed steps to prepare for my crime in the DPR Korea while I was in the United States. In order to know more about slogans in the DPR Korea, I did an internet Google image search with the keywords North Korea slogan in my rented Virginia apartment. I saw, well, over 30 images. Some were framed, but I thought that could easily be removed. They were large, red, and rectangular. They were printed on a thin metal that I thought could easily be folded to fit in my suitcase. On December 23rd, 2015, I stole street signs for practice, and I kept them under the bed in my rented Virginia apartment. Then, I discussed with my friend excuses that I could make. If detained, I plan to say that I was drunk and did not remember. If spotted with the slogan, I plan to falsely state that I had bought the slogan at a souvenir shop. That is why, at the start of the investigation, I tried to falsely state that I was drunk and had no idea. Then, on December 25th, 2015, I intentionally packed my quietest boots, the best for sneaking. I knew that I would wear them during my crime commitment. I also chose to bring a large suitcase to fit the slogan and made plans to buy a new suitcase in the DPR Korea if needed. Based on this detailed preparation, I came to commit my crime in the DPR Korea. Thank you all again for your continued attention. Thank you for your question. I will now explain the details of my crime commitment. On December 27th, 2015, I alone arrived in Beijing and spent 2 days looking around the city. On December 29th, 2015, I met my tour group at the Beijing International Airport. That afternoon, we arrived at the Pyongyang International Airport and we checked into the Yanggakdo International Hotel. While in Pyongyang, I prepared additionally for my crime. On the morning of December 30th, 2015, I asked my UK tour guide where they keep the important slogans in the Yanggakdo International Hotel. She said they are in staff-only areas. That night, I alone walked around the second floor lobby until I saw a staff-only sign, in English, opposite the hotel shop. I checked for cameras and saw none. I knew where I would commit my crime. I chose the early morning of January 1st, 2016, New Year's, because I thought there would be less employees for the holiday. I knew my tour group would be drunk, so I could use my planned excuse that I was just drunk like them. The next morning, December 31st, 2015, I intentionally wore my quietest boots, the ones that I had prepared while in the United States. Around 1 o'clock a.m. on January 1st, 2016, my tour group returned to the Yanggakdo International Hotel after looking at the Pyongyang night view. I took my coat and my items up to my room. Around 1:30 a.m., I joined my tour group at the second floor lobby draft beer bar. Then, I snuck away from the bar and quietly entered the staff-only area. I saw no one, and I saw the desired slogan hanging on a right side wall. I approached the wall and with two hands, grabbed the slogan at the bottom and removed it from the hangers. It was much bigger and heavier than I had expected. I became very scared, and I realized that I could not take the slogan. Hastily, I put it down, upside down. I snuck out of the staff-only area and ran up to my hotel room. I hope that clearly explains the details of my crime procedure. Thank you all again for your attention.
Hello, 중국 신화통신상태파 기자 유계입니다. 당신이 엄중한 범죄를 감행하여 현재 조사 중에 있다고 하는데 조선의 법기관으로부터 그 어떤 고문이나 심리적 압박을 받은 적이 있습니까?
Thank you for your question. I will now discuss my treatment while in the DPR Korea. As an American citizen detained for severe crimes in the DPR Korea, I had feared that I may receive torture or mental pressure. That was my totally wrong thinking. I have been given the most humanitarian treatment in a hotel class guest house with no torture or mental pressure. I am fed 3 meals daily of high quality, and I was given a full medical check. I am given 1 hour daily to walk outside. I am given a weekly sauna bath, and I was given a haircut. I sleep more than 8 hours nightly. As you all can see, I am healthy. But I miss my family very much. I have been very impressed by the Korean government's humanitarian treatment of severe criminals like myself, and of their very fair and square legal procedures in the DPR Korea. I am the most ashamed I have been in my life for committing a crime in such a friendly country. And, at least through this press conference, my family will see that I am in good health and find some relief. However, I miss that family so, so much. I understand the severity of my crime, and I have no idea what sort of penalty I may face, but I am begging to the Korean people and government for my forgiveness, and I am praying to the heavens so that I may be returned home to my family. I hope that clearly explains my humanitarian treatment while in the DPR Korea. Thank you all for listening again.
더 질문할 것이 없습니까? 질문이 없으면 완비오, 당신은 마지막으로 할 말이 더 없습니까?
Once again, I want to thank all of you for sparing the precious time to come to the press conference that I eagerly requested to have. I would also like to again show my sincere gratitude to the government of the DPR Korea for giving me this opportunity to beg for forgiveness. On the morning of January 1st, 2016, I made the worst decision of my life and committed a very severe crime against both the people and the government of the DPR Korea. I understand the severity of my crime. I have acted to harm the unity and ideological basis of your country. I am so ashamed of myself for the harm that I have caused. I entirely beg for forgiveness. I apologize to every one of the millions of Korean people, and I beg that you see how I was used and manipulated. My reward for my crime was so much smaller than the reward that the Friendship United Methodist Church and the Z Society get from the United States Administration. The United States Administration used me, like many before me. I am a victim of the United States Administration's consistent hostile policies against the DPR Korea. I wish that United States citizens who may follow in my precedents never, never allow yourselves to be allured by the United States administration. Through my tour in this country, I have come to see that reality in the DPR Korea is very different from the state of evils that the West tagged. And I have come to see that the current human rights issues in the DPR Korea, consistently highlighted by the United States administration, is nothing more than an excuse to harm and eventually overthrow the government of the DPR Korea. My dear United States citizens, seeing is believing, as the proverb goes. Please, come to Pyongyang, which one United States citizen long ago called an Eastern Jerusalem. Then you will believe me. Once again, I want to beg for forgiveness. Please, people in government of the DPR Korea, I beg that you see how I was used and manipulated. Please, act to save me. Save my life. Please, do not only think of me. Please forgive me for my family. I am the oldest son in my family. My mother needs me. My father needs me. My younger brother and my younger sister need me. I have made the single worst decision of my life. But I am only human. I beg that you consider that. And I beg that you find it in your hearts to give me forgiveness and allow me to return home to my family. I also beg that journalists accurately and objectively report my story and provide help of any kind. Thank you all for giving me this opportunity. After this press conference, my family will come to know about my current situation. I am very worried that they may be harmed. And, like I was manipulated by the United States administration, I am worried that they may be threatened or harmed by those from the government. I beg for any kind of public protection for my family. One final time, people in government of the DPR Korea, I beg for forgiveness. I never should have allowed myself to be allured by the United States administration to commit a crime in this country. I wish that the United States administration never manipulate people like myself in the future to commit crimes against foreign countries. I entirely beg you, people and government of the DPR Korea, for your forgiveness. Please, I have made the worst mistake of my life. Please, think of my family.
Is 이상으로 미국 국민 완비 오토 프레드리코와의 기자회견을 마치겠습니다.